Got up early this morning and drove an hour and a half west on the Pennsylvania Turnpike to get to, where am I? Rockhill Furnace, Pennsylvania, for the Rockhill Trolley Museum. We're going to shoot around this morning and see if we can't get some still photos of the trolley cars that are here. Saw pictures of it. Seems like a really neat place, so let's check it out. I like the texture of the paint peeling off the wood here. Check this out. A green on red here. And the there's just layers of pattern. There's the pattern of the grain of the wood. There's the pattern of the circle of wire. Then there's the random pattern of the green vine growing up through there. East Broadtop sign, Steam Railroad. This a car barn?
Yes, sir. This is where the Rockville Trolley Museum and East Broadtop Railroad keep all their equipment. This is our snow sweeper. It came from an Iowa terminal company. It was a basically a pretty standard design of the snow sweepers that ran a lot of transit railroads. They couldn't really run plows through the streets. They would sweep up snow. So it's a pretty typical example of what a transit railroad would have. This is our open car. It came from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. It was built in the early 1900s by the J.G. Brill Company, and it came to them as a kit. So all the metalwork came out of Philadelphia, was sent down to Rio, and then they added their own natural wood. So all the interior wood is all cherry from Brazil and mahogany. So it's a very rare wood car, and there's only a couple of these in the country. A lot of trolley museums bought them in the 60s when Rio was getting up the service. 55. This one came from Johnstown, Pennsylvania. It's one of our Pennsylvania trolley cars, which is where we try to focus our collection towards. And we got this one completely overhauled in 2005. And they took as much of the original material as they could. And the company that we had refurbished it basically built us a new car. A lot of side sheet material was all new. I believe it's all new window glass. A lot of the interior wood, what could be saved was saved, and they just replaced as new. And of course they rebuilt the trucks and whatnot. So we put that one back in service, I believe 2005, and this has been our one of our main trolley cars since then. And if we cross over here, it's a little dirty. This trolley right here is an example of a PCC car, a President's Commerce Committee car. In the 30s, the streetcar companies were going out of business. They were running these antique trolleys and they weren't really efficient, they weren't really doing a good job. They kind of required two people to operate. And these cars were a very, very, very successful design. What trolley companies that survived the early Great Depression were definitely helped by this design. You can run it with essentially one person. Everyone gets on one or two ends. The fare register is able to be controlled by the operator, and you didn't really need to have a conductor for these. For all this, all restoration work was done outside. We had a shop to keep our tools in, but it had no tracks into it. We had no real pit. So this really put us a step above most museums of the time period. So we were able to put about two trolleys in here at one time so we can have two projects going. We have a wood shop and a metal shop on both ends and a welding area over here.
Look at the texture on this door here, which used, the door used to be red, but I think we got a photo here. There's pictures everywhere out here. Don't really know the quality of them until you get back and play with them a little bit in the computer, but a lot of opportunities out here. A little chilly, down below freezing last night, and hands and feet are a little cold here, but getting some good shots. I'm walking on the one right now. Look at the texture on this wall. Might not be able to see it. Let me get closer.
This is the only one left of the five. And it took 17 years to restore this car because it was so rare. It was built in 1924, and we've already run it here longer than it was in its original commercial life.
The car actually rolls really good. So we could actually throw power back at the switch and it would almost drift all the way back into the station. For the full load like this, it's a little harder to pull back up.
That pretty much concludes our trolley ride today and tour of the museum here at the Trolley Museum. So I'll go ahead and hit the subscribe button and we'll see you in the next video.